Hello, my name is Margaret Adele, and I am super excited because it is the best part of my BookTube year, and that is in December. Now, it isn't actually in December as I'm filming this or uploading this. It's November, but I'm giving everyone a little bit of extra time to get ready. Now, if you don't know, in December is kind of a readathon, but not in the way that BookTube knows them. The point of Indiecember is to review indie books on places like Amazon or Goodreads. A lot of indie authors struggle to get those reviews, and it's really the best marketing tactic for them. So Indiecember, the community makes a point of going out and giving all of the reviews. And there's also a lovely way to quote unquote win in December and maybe get some prizes. The lovely Megan Tennant, who is the originator of this review-a-thon, made a bingo board. And there are two different ways to win. You can get a standard line, like in regular bingo, or you can cover the entire thing. Now, if you're going for a line, you can only count each book once. However, if you're covering the entire thing, the book can count for multiple different prompts. And these prompts involve things like how many reviews a book have, the colors on it, genre, that kind of thing. So last year, I only managed to do a line. I was a baby BookTuber. I didn't really have a lot of experience in reading any books, like, concertedly, like, in an effort. But this year, I am covering that sucker, and I'm super excited about it. And I also have a ton of recommendations, more than I'm actually going to give you in this video, because we don't have that much time. So, if you'd like to know a little bit more about Indiecember, I will have that in the description below. I may also have reviews for the books if I have reviewed them. I will not have reviewed all of these books on my channel, so be sure to go down and look at those as well. But let's jump right into it. My trusty notes. Alright, so for the prompt of a book with a red cover, I would recommend The Songbird's Refrain by Jillian Maria. Granted, the cover's more like orangish red, but I think it still counts. This is a queer YA fantasy horror where a young girl goes to this kind of artsy show and ends up trapped in a cage and feathers begin to grow all over her body. She has to figure out why the mistress that's done this to her hates her and how to get out of it. I love this. It's very spooky. If you liked Wilder Girls, you will love that one. For the prompt released in 2019, I have two recommendations. The first being Soulfire by Chaz Harris. This is a mid-grade fantasy with LGBT themes, all about a young boy who discovers that the mythical world that his grandfather told him about is actually real, and he has to help save it. And he also might have a crush on another boy in his class. Love that so much. The second one is for Dead Remnants by Armana Forbes. This is a YA paranormal about a young girl who is killed and has to navigate the ghost realm. She's constantly being requested to join these factions. She's trying to find her best friend in the afterlife, and she has to do all this on a time limit because if she doesn't cross over within a certain time, she can't cross over at all. I adore this one, and I think you just might as well. Up next for the prompt non-Western inspired, I'm so happy that I have three different recommendations for this one. The first one is Deference by Leela Mina. This is a polyamorous romance set in Japan. Now, Leela is a white woman. However, she lives in Japan, so it is still authentic representation in that way. The culture is still a culture that she lives in and has daily interactions with. I love all three of the characters in the poly romance, and I would, I'm so jazzed to read the third in that trilogy, so I would highly suggest that. Although, I will say the sex scenes are very graphic, so be warned about that going in. The second one is For the Seven Kinds by Dilip Mighty. This is Own Voices Indian psychological horror, and that is Indian in the Indian. He is Indian himself, and all the stories are set there. There are some very disturbing moments, so go into that knowing that you're kind of getting some iffy times, but I really did appreciate that perspective. And third is For Cenote City by Monique Quintana. This is a very trippy, surreal novella all about this Mexican family that lives around a cenote and the political ramifications that they had to deal with, as well as some magical realism. Now, I personally didn't vibe with it as much, but I have heard from other reviewers that are from that community that it is a very good representation of that community. So don't be put off by my review. If you're from that community, it's authentic. It just, my white girl brain apparently didn't go for it. For the prompt of a dystopian or a post-apocalyptic story, I have two different takes for you. If you like your post-apocalypse or dystopian with a lot of bleakness, I would go with Home by David Kummer. This is a short story or novella, depending, about four teens who are traveling this very bleak, inhospitable place to get to a place called home that may or may not be a good place, with a really trippy overlay and very strange ending. And it's very bleak, and so you gotta be on the lookout for that. However, if you want something a little less bleak with a little more hope, then I would suggest Until the End of the World by Sarah Lyons Fleming. This is about a young woman who basically self-destructed her life after the death of her doomsday prepper parents, but when the zombie apocalypse breaks out, she gets to break out all of the skills that her parents taught her, and as well as go across the countryside to try to reconnect with her long-lost love. It is technically the first in the series, but I actually like it as a standalone. The ending is very sweet, and I would highly suggest that one. Up next is the prompt for comedy called Jolly, and I would recommend Duckett and Dyer, Dicks for Hire by G.M. Nair. This is a trippy satire all about this pair of roommates who realize that someone's putting up ads for their detective agency, but they don't have one. It's hard to explain. Very strange things ensue. They end up like dimension hopping and time traveling, and it's weird, but in the best way. And G.M. Nair just has a great... Oh, he's so good at sarcasm and, like, weird humor. I love it. Up next, for fantasy, aka magical, I have two prompts. The first is Tavern by Dustin Munden. This is a D&D-style slice-of-life high fantasy all about this orc named Zelnath who is trying to, you know, do his day-to-day life as well as lead this guild of spies, essentially, when this big baddie comes into town and has a bone to pick with him. I love this one because it is an orc protagonist who is coded to be black, and the author himself is black, so in a weird way, it's kind of like fantasy-owned voices, and it's so surreal. I'm so excited for the next one, you guys. I also have Prince Norov, Edge of Shadows by J.T. Harris. This is a YA fantasy all about this young prince who finds himself with a ton of magic he doesn't really want that may low-key be illegal for him to have, and is being chased by a bunch of different people who want to get at the magic. And the ending of this book is also, like, trippy, and I hopefully will get to the sequel soon because I gotta know. For the prompt, mythology-inspired, I would highly recommend Pomegranate by Nicole Scarano. This is the myth of Hades, but gender-bent. So Hades is not the brother of Zeus and Poseidon, but Zeus's female lover, who is put aside when he has to marry Hera. She gets cast out of Olympus down to the underworld, but there uncovers her real power and becomes the god of death she was always meant to be. Also the beginning of a series, and I also love it. For the prompt, animal characters, aka friends of Rudolph, I would recommend Nightmare Arcanist by Shammy Stovall. If you've been on my channel for any length of time, you know that Shammy Stovall is one of my insta-read authors, and this one is no different. This is a flintlock fantasy world where everyone who is a magician, called an arcanist, is matched with this Eldrin being who most often is an animal character, sometimes not. But it revolves around this young boy who finally gets his arcanist, or finally becomes an arcanist with his Eldrin. Only his Eldrin informs him that not only did he have an arcanist before him, but he was murdered, and he needs his new arcanist to avenge that. I adored it. The world is just so awesome. It's so cute, and Vilka's adorable soft boy that I love. I would highly recommend that. Up next, for the erotica prompt, aka naughty, I have a lot of suggestions for this one. Bunny and the Bear by Eve Langlais is the beginning of the Furry United Coalition series. It is a very tongue-in-cheek shifter romance. I know exactly what it is, and it's just, I can't even explain it, but if you like silly erotica, that is definitely the one for you. However, if you would like some more, like, angsty, high-emotional erotica, then I suggest you check out Pierced by Sydney Landon. This is all about a young college student who meets up with a young billionaire, aka 50 Shades of Grey, but much less toxic and abusive, and they both have very, very traumatic pasts that they must get through to finally come together in the healthy way that they're supposed to. Definitely a lot of angst, definitely a lot of emotion, so be prepared. Oh, also low-key trigger warnings for sexual assault. Gotta remember that one. Thirdly, for this prompt, I have Red Moon by Elizabeth Kelly. This takes place in a very far-off future where humanity has basically gone through a post-apocalypse and started to rebuild. So it's kind of like in a weird, looks medieval, but also sometimes they have electronic stage. And there's werewolves, and it's erotica. And again, it's one of those things you gotta have to love, but I mean, I love it, so it's fine. Nightmare Before Christmas, aka horror. I got a couple different options for you here as well. The Revenants by Mary Hallberg is zombies. It is a novella. It is fairly by the book, but well done. The ambiance is very creepy, and I appreciate the ending that she went for. I thought it was very bold. Cade's Cove, The Curse of Allie Mae is a ghost story revolving around a young, not young couple, middle-aged couple that goes on an anniversary trip and brings back this strange little bag of treasures that may have a ghost attached with it that particularly hates their eldest son. I was on the fence about whether or not this one was a 3 or a 4. However, if you like creepy ghost stories, this one will probably be right up your alley. And lastly, probably my favorite of my recommendations, I have Blood Drops by W.B. Welch. This is a short story collection of horror stories, and they're all deliciously bad in the best way. And I highly suggest it, although be on the lookout, it may make your skin crawl at times. For the contemporary prompt, 3 more recommendations for you. Matters of Convenience by Roy L. Pickering Jr. This is about 3 young black adults living in the city. We have a young woman, the man that has been in love with her for years, but she doesn't feel the same way, and the new man that she seems very intrigued in. I will warn you, this is not a standard HEA romance as you might think it is. At the beginning, it is very messy, and you might not like all the characters by the end, but I thought it was very powerful, and I love that it was own voices because 90% of the cast and the author are black. We also have Vices and Virtues by Beatrice Di Sopranto. This is about a young woman working as a dom in not exactly like a sex dungeon, but like a little bit shy of that. And it's less focused on the steamy scenes as much as it is using those scenes to talk about the different vices and virtues as we know them, like the 7 deadly sins and such. This is definitely more philosophically bent, but I loved how each of the different doms that work there gets their own backstory, and there are a lot of different takes and a lot of different cultures included, so I appreciated that. Up next, we also had The Mermaid Upstairs by Jamie Lilo. This is about a teenage girl who gets in a car accident with her mother, and something about the accident has her mother's memory wiped, and she now believes that she is a mermaid on land, and the teenage girl must kind of combat that. I wrestled with this one a little bit because at times it did feel like it was taking it a little bit too cartoonish. However, after thought, I can say that this does say a lot about the pressures especially put on older women in the business realm and how mental health and mental health breaks are really important. So I would really suggest that one as well. Sci-fi. Okay, I could recommend like a kajillion, but I'll stick to my top 2. And that is Starmark Rising by Shami Stovall. This is about a man living on a space station who hates living on a space station and wants to go planet side. So when a strange space captain in this kind of military setting offers him that chance, if he comes and works for her, he jumps at it. But what exactly does it mean working for her, and what is it going to take to get there? I adored this. The ending was explosive. I have been pestering Shami Stovall for the sequel ever since, and probably will until I have it in my hands. Second, I have Star Nomad by Lindsay Broker, my other sci-fi space opera fave. This is about a pilot named Elisa Marchenko who did really well during the war to overthrow the Empire, but post-Empire fallen, she's basically forgotten about on this desert planet and wants nothing more than to get home to her daughter. But she has to take on this crew of ragtag people to pay their way to actually get there, and gets sidetracked a lot and discovers things. And I currently just read like the 4th book in this series, and I am in love with it. Definitely, definitely, definitely suggest that one. Up next, Romance, aka Mistletoe. I've got 2 more suggestions for you. Paper Flowers by Andy Barr. This is an MLM romance. Now, Andy Barr is a woman. However, she did have sensitivity readers and beta readers that were queer men. So it does come from a place of research to an extent. This is about a young man named Jake who's working in a florist shop. And Max comes in to get flowers for his sister's wedding and sparks begin to fly. I loved it. It was adorable. I'm super excited that it's a series. We also have Blood Match by Gina Moran. This was the first reverse harem romance I found that actually did what I wanted it to do. This is about a young woman who lives in a world where vampires are the ruling elite and every human can sign up to become a donor. But she ends up being a perfect match for 3 different vampire brothers, and they're basically trying to decide who she's best fit with. Does she have to choose? And on top of that, this family of vampires has some very big enemies that would like nothing more than to take their new blood match away. Up next for the prompt, mystery or thriller, I have Then Came Darkness by D.H. Schleicher. This is a Great Depression set serial killer story, essentially all about a man who was screwed over in a job and is now penniless, even more penniless because Great Depression, and decides to take revenge on the family that screwed him over. It is dark. It is bleak. It is Steinbeck with more murder. I loved it, and I think you might too. I also have The Gowgwin Connection by Estelle Ryan. This is a bit more lighter of a mystery all about a woman with autism who has made studying human behavior into an art form as to kind of keep up with the world as she can't normally see that kind of thing, and so gets pulled in to helping uncover various art fraud, and it is so adorable. Beginning of a series, and again, highly recommend. For White and Blue on the cover, two more suggestions for you. Only Words by Summer Kiska. This is the first in the Shane Aspie trilogy, all about a witch who is cursed to only have a certain number of words left. The problem being that her magic uses words, and someone might be coming to kill her. And on top of that, now this warlock comes in and he needs help learning his magic, but she's still mute. But he is an adorable soft boy. I loved this book. I am also pestering Summer Kiska for the sequel. I have pestered Summer Kiska for the sequel in the In December Discord. So I would highly suggest that one. And Ella the Slayer by A.W. Exley. This asks, what if Cinderella lived during the Edwardian period post-World War I and killed zombies? I love this. This is both awesome in that it was very much set in the time period. It was very much Edwardian post-World War I. And also, Cinderella is a badass zombie slayer. Like, everything works. For the prompt, novella or poetry, I would pick Radiant Souls by Lynae H. This is some very, very uplifting poetry. There's also poetry based on a non-binary recipient with they, them used in the singular sense. Or you can use Breaking Free by Catlin Derwan. This is all about a very dark period in her life and how she came out to the other side. So it is one of those tales of resilience and endurance told through poetry, and I very much appreciated it. I only could find one prompt for over 500 pages because apparently I don't read a lot of indie books that long, but there is The Battle for Metagor by D.L. Stewart. This is a thick, high fantasy, just over 500 pages, all about this world that collapses when its kind and noble leader dies, and the lesser lords decide that they don't like how they picked the next one, and they kind of all decide to go to war with each other. Very gory, metagory, and very, very, very thick world building, so be on the lookout for that. And the last one, and this a little bit feels like pandering, but it's the most obvious choice. For green on the cover, I would pick Alethea by Megan Tennant. Yes, Megan Tennant is the one that kind of created the hole in December, but green on the cover. It's got so much green. This is a new adult dystopian all about this strange compound that was built after a virus destroyed half the world, and this nameless girl who was given a number, realizing that the compound she was a part of is horrible, and decides that with the help of some people on the outside, some survivors, she is not only going to break out, but break out all of the other nameless with her. I adore this book. I have fan fiction for this book. I would highly, highly suggest it. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little bit proud of myself that this video is around only 20 minutes. I was afraid it would be longer, so I'm gonna cut it off right here. If you are interested in doing in December, please tell me. Let me know down in the description below. We got a Discord. I'm super excited to get everyone involved in indie books. It's gonna be so much fun. I am actually doing this at the same time as I am doing the Book Junkie Trials Winter Edition, so it's a lot, but I'm super excited for all of this. December is going to be so much fun, and I hope you come along with me. And with nothing else to say, I hope you have a wonderful day and a marvelous tomorrow.